Dear students of class 7, today's my chapter is I like to discuss the chapter 4, more regional kingdoms. Kingdoms in the West. We see that several kingdoms flourished or emerged in the western part of India: Gujarat, Malwa, Marwar and Mewar, etc. Gujarat, you know that it is a very fertile land. It has trade ports, and perhaps in the year 1407, Zafar Khan founded it. He adopted the title Muzaffar Shah. His grandson was Ahmad Shah, who shifted the capital from Patan to Ahmedabad. It was founded in the year 1413. And another, you see that the ruler of this dynasty, Mahmud Begada, one of the greatest leader, military leader, he also captured forts of Junagadh, and he built actually and Champnar forts at Biraga. You see that the captured the force of Junagadh and Champnar. Now, the another kingdom was Malwa. There is a conflict always went on for a long between the Malwa and Gujarat. Malwa is situated in the high, see that the plateau of the river Narmada and Tapti. It was capital at Dhaur, which was later shifted to Mandu. And Hosang Shah was one of the greatest ruler, fought with the Gujarat, you know that, and we see that the similarly, I may mention that Odisha, Bahumani Sultans, etc., Sultans of Delhi. Then Marwar and Mewar, Rana Kumbho, it is one of the greatest ruler of this dynasty. Rana Kumbho, he was a great patron of art and architecture. He himself also a great scholar. He built the Victory Stambha, Vijay Stambha at Chittor. We see that he was succeeded by Rana Sangho. Rana Sangho also defeated the Lodi Sultans, but he was himself defeated by Babur when the Battle of Khanwa in 1527. Rana Sangho was defeated by Babur. We see that the kingdoms on the northeast, that is Jaunpur. Jaunpur, it is I discussed about the kingdoms in the west, now kingdoms in the northeast. Jaunpur, the Malik Sarwar was the founder. We see that they adopted the title. It is during the time of, see that Firoz Shah Tughlaq, that declared during the time of Firoz Shah Tughlaq, Malik Sarwar declared himself independent, and he adopted the title Sarkis, or Malik Uz Sarki, meaning Lord of the East. And during that time, Jaunpur became the center of artistic and literary activities. We see that the many architecture also developed during this time. Tall buildings, lofty towers. We see the tall and lofty gates and large arches also were features of the Jaunpur architecture. Then Bengal. The Ilyas Shahi and Husain Shahi's dynasty also ruled during this time, and the Ilyas Shahi and Husain Shahi rulers, Alauddin Husain Shah, for example, fought with the Delhi Sultans. It is said Firoz Shah Tughlaq once led a campaign in Bengal, but he was not successful. Next with the Kashmir. Kashmir, the most powerful and important ruler was Jainul Abedin. He was called Akbar of Kashmir, very tolerant to all religions, and under his patronage, the Sanskrit literature was translated into Arabic and Persian language. we see that the Sanskrit text into Persian. We know that under his patronage, the Kalhanas Rastarangini was translated. Kalhanas Rastarangini, Kalhan was the Kashmiri poet, etc. However, he was great. So, ruler, one of the greatest ruler of the Kashmir. Next, we see that the kingdoms in the south, that is the Vijayanagar kingdom. The founder is Harihar Bukka. The Harihar Bukka belonged to the Sangama dynasty. And the four dynasties altogether ruled in Vijayanagar: Sangam dynasty, Saluva dynasty, Tuluva and Arvidu dynasty. Sangam, Saluva, Tuluva and Arvidu. See that the greatest ruler of this Vijayanagar dynasty was, Vijayanagar kingdom was Krishnadevaraya. Krishnadevaraya belonged to the Tuluva dynasty. He was a great scholar and he also defeated the Gajapati kingdoms and Bahamani rulers. And Gajapati, see that he annexed many territories from the Gajapati rulers. Similarly, he was a great scholar. He wrote a book in Telugu language called Amukta Mallora. He was a great patron of Tamil, Telugu and Kannada language. And many scholars adorned his court. And similarly, the foreigners came to be during his, many foreigners visited during his time. One of them was Dominic Pease, a Portuguese traveler. He also praised him much that it is the Krishnadevaraya was a man of justice and great ruler. So this is in brief similarly the Bahamani kingdom was founded by Hasan Gangu. It is the Hasan Gangu was came to be known as Alauddin Hussein Bahman Shah. See that ruler of the Bahamani kingdom, another greatest ruler, the Firoz Shah Bahamani. And you see that about the economy and administration and architecture and Bahamani kingdom, I shall discuss later. So thank you all. And next day, I like to discuss the economy, administration and also architecture and Bahamani kingdom. Thank you.